How do your products use or challenge conventions, and how do they represent social groups or issues? As always, I had kind of a love-hate relationship with conventions. In some cases, I follow them religiously, and in other cases, I make a 180-degree turn against them. Like most creative artists, it's more about what feels right rather than what rules have been set. I began my project by following the obligatory conventions, such as making questionnaires to get a better idea of what my audience expects, and doing my mandatory research regarding the music video digipack, website, and genre without which the next step cannot be taken. There is somewhat of a debate going on regarding the necessity of storyboards. I, for one, was in favor of the convention as it saves a lot of time and energy on set and gives you set targets to complete. However, there is always room for improvisation, so I took the risk of not planning my shoot with the kids with storyboards and relying more on candid shots. This method completely goes against conventions, but it worked out perfectly for me. In fact, my footage came out much better than expected. I followed some major principles for shooting a music video. I used two lenses, one zoom and one prime. However, I did not use the zoom feature at all, as it is uncommon to do so to achieve the conventional film look. To get this look, I shot on 24 frames per second, which is cinema standard, and I chose the aspect ratio of 235 to 1 to get that traditional film look. I used similar conventional techniques while filming, such as the famous rule of thirds. It's hard to go wrong with the rule of thirds, okay? My music video defied almost all laws of hip-hop rap music videos. My video was not nearly as graphic, intense, or explicit as most rap music videos are. I had to take a major turn from conventions of this genre, as the majority of my audience was aged 13 to 17 years old and wanted to see a video with a message. So I guess in a way I was still following the conventions my audience had created. I added opening and ending credits in the bottom left corner of the frame, as can be seen in most music videos. I added the date, the year, as the father and daughter were growing older, as can be seen in most music videos set over a long period of time. The costumes I chose were the type you would see standard performers wearing in music videos. Especially for the graduation and wedding scenes, I made my cast wear traditional graduation robes, and for the wedding scenes, dresses and suits. I wanted to make these scenes look as realistic and convincing as possible, and I believe I got pretty close. I really tried to combat the conventional gender roles placed by our society in this video, as we see a single dad raising his daughter. Most people would expect household activities without a lady to go horribly wrong, because for a long time our society has believed that a woman's job is merely to manage the house. I attempted to challenge that ideology in this video by showing how it is not at all easy without a mother and a wife around, and she is missed by their hearts instead of their kitchen. I showed that despite them being a mess in the kitchen, they're happy and are still trying to learn, and it isn't moments like these, but the more important moments, like the birthdays, graduation, and wedding, when they truly miss mom. Another convention that I noticed in a lot of similar music videos but did not end up following was the flashback. I didn't use transitions such as fades or dissolves, which are very commonly used in music videos, as I felt my video was complete without them, and this would just overdo it. These techniques are very powerful and useful, but they are just not for this music video. When it comes to my digipack, I think it was pretty conventional. I had the album name nice and big on the cover, with the names of the artists at the bottom, which are on top in a lot of magazines too. Sorry, albums. In a lot of, yes. I added the price in the bottom right and tried to keep it realistic. The back of the album had the list of songs in the album. The name of the songs aren't very conventional in respect to the genre, but considering the type and feel of this album, I believe they were just fine. I even added a barcode, as can conventionally be found on albums for sale. The website had tabs you would find on most music websites, especially the BTS and Contact tab. That is a must. It was, however, missing some album art in my opinion, and there is no option to buy or order the album from the website. There also isn't any merchandise for sale, nor are any tour or release dates being displayed. These are some things that I wish I could have added. I believe my product did a good job highlighting the emotions of single parents and the father-daughter relationship in particular. It just shows how much a father loves his daughter and her whole life, and in the blink of an eye, he's walking her down the aisle and watches her drive off into the unknown. I wanted to capture that moment where he is left all alone at the end, despite all that he's done and sacrificed for her. It also speaks to orphans or kids of divorce growing up with one parent compared to other kids with normal childhoods getting love and affection from both their parents. The wedding scene speaks to an array of people. It goes to show how emotional weddings can be. They can make you happy and sad at the same time, because you walk into this new phase of life, because to walk into this new phase of life, you have to leave the old one behind.